Firstly, if you use that product, use that product, does that produce a specification for
it would do, yeah. So at this point, I've just sort of listed it, it's a sort of beta testing thing, but absolutely, it will produce a push button specification. Here you go. Hopefully, it meets the performance requirements of the NSF.
Big question, BIM. Interface from BIM?
Not yet. Maybe in a year's time, I'll start to think about it. It's not been the focus, but the focus of Speckle, the project, is that, hey, we've just increased the stringency of energy efficiency so vastly that we're bringing up a lot of people. This is not just for the top 10%, right? This is 50-60% of people that are going to make an effort around energy efficiency. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to encourage a far greater narrative in that space. And it's just not top end of town that's playing in the big space.
So it's some of the high-end programs, that program, of course, you can preset any wall tools and you can have to look at preset all that information.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sit out and bring down.
Yeah, we've looked at that. Yeah. We're a part of the team at the time, but we're going to meet them down at the time. When we do something
else. Yeah, you know, yeah, listen, then putting it back into the window, see, I don't know how that's all day.
Yeah, all about shared parameters on that big model, that big panel.
Yeah.
Based on the order.
But yeah, just producing those sort of outputs. It's just time, right?
So would your particular company have a suite of window door models which we can import into the air program?
Yeah, it's just
where
you're using the shared
parameters. Yeah, I'm sort of updating.
Yeah.
Really interesting.
So those values will be based on values that come out of this product.
View there.
Speckle seems like a wonderful tool to help you design a window and make it compliant, where it gives you all the values and it gives you all the compliance issues that you need. But does it also give you the quality surveyor and the value?
The value
is not a person sitting in this room who's not subject to cost constraints on a project. No one designed the building with a blank checkbook. So unless you've got a dollar value against each of those systems.
Yeah. Sure, well, the two things that we put together, you get a price, but you do this, you work out routes, and you do a modification based on it, makes it a spread rate from the.
Yeah, the way I would say, if you're ticking the boxes here and you go to market for the price, right? the prices you get back are going to be real world. They're not sending out the number before the product and getting another kind of value cost and then having to go up the price to get to where you need to be at the end of the system.
I mean, it seems that the tool that you're providing them will give you half a dozen systems, which will meet the criteria.
Possibly so.
Possibly so.
Yeah, absolutely. But saying if you're talking 100, 150, once again, it's a little about energy. It doesn't take any account wind performance, water performance, acoustics, bush fire, purely energy. And that's not a pretty good starting point compared to what we've got now. But I call me if you want some possible
energy.
Do you have any thermal braking systems that are cyclone rated?
That is.
You can help with that.
Yeah, absolutely. In region C and D.
Yeah.
Generally in region D, then you're talking about something like the leasing class, so what is the impact factor? And it's almost the glass is structurally glazed within the pop, or the patch structurally glazed within the pop to resist that sort of impact. So for the quality of the sort of whole.
So the R values for a solid wall, are we going to be driven to external insulation? And what might that material be?
In this climate, there is an opportunity to go that way from a vapor transfer point of view.
Is that the only way we're going to be able to achieve those values?
Yeah.
Without.
No, the vapors are achievable through stud framing. If you've got steel framing system, you're we've introduced these things that were introduced, and the fact that we're encouraging combustible products to be installed, but we can't.
Double brakes go in there as well.
Yeah. Double brakes are as combustible. The people that have been providing those products to market have been pulling them off the market of late because they know that they can't be lying to products. So, what was the asbestos, was it? We can go asbestos for the double brake. So there was a discussion earlier about that exact topic. How are we actually going to thermally break steel structure? And it's a very, very difficult thing. We've got no opportunity to do that. So unless you start packing out loads of timber. It's a challenge. I've got no answer to that one. That's going to be a smart material supply.
So has AWS done any costing studies between, say, 2016 compliant hospital to 2019?
Yeah, we have. You referred to release that study probably initially or so. Quite again, it's dependent on climate zone versus building size. There's a whole lot of arrangements, but yeah, actually, you register obviously, I'm quite happy to send that out to you guys when that comes out. And hopefully, it's going to be that.
The Speckle include for external shading as well, particularly large overhead.
In its first release, it won't be by the end of this month that is going to be added. So we're still running through the technicalities of the vertical and horizontal. Mm-hmm. Particularly on the horizontal side, the additional thermal bridging as a result of frequent horizontal brackets. So we're running through those nuances now, but by the end of this month it will be. There's a 7-day free access on it, so, and what I would say, guys, just, it's only $99 per month to use this thing. You get free access. The only time we charge you per project is when you activate a project, and we only charge you 1 month at a time. If you stop using it, it doesn't charge you. It's automated, okay? So it's a very, very low cost option for understanding these provisions. It's not heavy.